Hello everyone, welcome back to DIY RC. In today's episode we are going to start a new DIY Trainer 2.0 build series that will be built even stronger and more durable than the first one and should fly super easy when you're taking off and landing, one of the most difficult maneuvers from flying. And the 2.0 stands for two different airfoils that we're going to use. We're going to use a normal low airfoil and a high airfoil on the outside tips of the wing. And the high airfoil is really good for flying at low speeds when taking off and coming in for a landing. And you can still fly at a high speed with the aerodynamic inner foil that's on the inside of the wings. And when you're coming in for landing and flying slower and slower and slower, and at inside of the wing that aerodynamic airfoil start losing lift and maybe stalls, then still the outside tips of the wings with the higher airfoil will keep on producing lift and keeping the plane in the air and stable. I already tried this wing on my last build, my FPV plane. A lot of people thought it was a weird design, but the wing proved itself flying absolutely stable and super flying like it was on rails. And I read a lot of your comments back then, and people asked for the same wing but then smaller that fits inside your car. This time we're going to build a wing that is 1 meter and it should fit in any car, small or big. Right here on the table are all the stuff that you're going to need. The 2.0 stands also for two materials that we're going to use. We're going to be using Corvallut, or I should say plastic cardboard, as the underside of the wing. And then of course just a normal wooden spar. And then foam as the top side of the wing, because it creates a nice smooth round airfoil. And it remains that airfoil, it keeps its memory after you have been pressing it with a roller. And it's super smooth and easy to work with and light, because the downside of plastic cardboard is that it's much heavier. But it's almost watertight and a lot stronger and perfect for the underside. And this foam is isolation board that you can find for under wooden floors. So that's a good tip. Another thing that you need is of course a good hot glue gun, a big one. I'll find the links down below. And plenty of tape. I'm very proud of my blue tape. This big roll that will last me a very long time. And then we're gonna need that to make it really strong. And there was enough talking, let's start with building. Starting with the cardboard Corvallut. It is 1 meter long, 100 centimeters, and 15 centimeters wide. And then the wooden dowel, the highest point of this wing, is going to be at 20%. So that's at 3 centimeters, where we make our first mark. And the wooden dowel is going to be sitting right in the middle. It will be the highest point of the wing. Now I'm going to make a full line, one end to the next. In the next step, with the hot glue gun warmed up, we can glue in the wooden dowel. Make sure you use a strong wood that you can use as a spar. It won't break easy. Also check how the grains are running. Reinforcement behind the spar that we're going to double up at the same height of the spar. And I like to be using my liner to put pressure on it over the entire length. And then we put another hot glue on top. You always got extra supply so you don't run out halfway through your work. Very quick. And you put the second spar on top. It is now the same height as the spar, giving you that extra reinforcement. Now we're going to do one more in front of the spar. And we glue that small one in. And we still have room for the foam to get that nice aerodynamic airfoil. Go to the next step and glue this in. And now with that last support glued in its place, reinforcing the spar completely done. It's time to get ready to prepare the foam, getting its bevel edge. You take the foam right up to the edge of the table, get your knife on an angle, and make sure it's very sharp. Glue first at the front, then I'm gonna glue it in the middle and on top of the spar, looking all the way to the back. But to keep this nice round shape, we're going to pre-bend the foam with a roller. I'm just gonna start right at the front lip and press and roll until we get a nice round airfoil shape. And just be really quick. Make sure that you line everything up really nice. Good. Press down on it. even push on it. Now we're gonna do a hot glue right on top of the bar, on the wooden spar. And now we turn the ring around, upside down. We're gonna do one dot of glue right here at the back, and then close up the wing, and then trim it off that excess foam that we don't need. And that's how you create that nice, perfect airfoil that we talked about. Now, for the 2.0 airfoil, high and low, we're just going to add an extra layer of foam on top of the tips of the wing. It's going to be 25 centimeters long. So you have 50 centimeters of high airfoil and 50 centimeters in the middle of an aerodynamic airfoil. For 50% good at flying fast and 50% good at flying slow. Then we got the foam prep with an angle and pre-bend. It's time to glue it on top. And then the last step. Now we got a high airfoil and a low airfoil. Good for flying slow, good for flying fast. Helping you a lot with taking off and giving you straight away a stable plane. If you're lining up for a landing, the plane will be very stable. The only downside of it is that now we have a very, very thick end that creates a lot of drag. You can solve that with a thicker aileron that tapers off to a very smooth end. You also create that extra high airfoil if you're gonna sand it down to a very smooth end. Then the curve will be even higher, working even better, and saving a little bit of weight. You can make sure that we do that in the correct way, sending it off just behind the highest point of the airfoil. We're gonna create and set a line. Now we're just gonna sand it nice and evenly. The last and final step is taping the wing. I'm gonna use two colors to make a difference, so it's gonna be very visible what is the top and what is the underside of the plane. And I will start first with a horizontal layer all over around the plane. Then we're gonna do a vertical layer around the plane from the bottom side all the way back to the bottom, tape to tape. That makes it extra strong. And then we're also going to overlap it a little bit from side to side to side to side to side to side. And when you start with the horizontal tape, I always start at the back of the wing, working my way forward. After we are done with the horizontal tape and color tape, we're gonna do one extra layer vertically around the wing, tape to tape, making it extra strong and protecting the nice colors blue and red. And it's always smart to mark the center of your wing before starting with the second layer of tape. And I will start in the middle of the wing, working yourself way to the outside of the wing. That was the final touch to the DIY RC Plane and Plane 2.0. If you want, you can choose, of course, to put ailerons into it right now, but I'm going to wait and first turn this plane into a 3-channel plane and make sure that the vertical stabilizer, elevator and rudder are working perfectly and perfectly sized. I really hope you like this episode. I'd like to see continue of the build. Then please subscribe if you're new to this channel. And if you're looking for parts to build this plane yourself for around $5, then you can be finding the links, of course, down below in the description. I want to thank you all for watching to the end of the video, and I hope to see you next time. Goodbye.